This key was purchased off eBay, and I had to get a locksmith to cut it. Lowe's or Home Depot most likely won't cut it, or they won't know how. So I have my old key. In fact, I have two old keys, and you have to have them. You cannot just get by with one. Open your truck door unlock button. Now you can put in your old key. Turn it 8 times, and you can count 8 times to do so. Now I'm putting in the new key that I had cut. I'm going to turn it 8 times. I count it as I do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now that's just the buttons to unlock and lock the door. That's it. It will not start the truck. So we're going to do that next. So now you have the two original keys. You're going to find out that one is a primary key and one is a secondary key. It may take a couple tries to figure out which is which, but you want to put your primary in first to get the programming started. So I do it 8 times. So if you don't get it right the first time, put the other key in and it could be your primary key. And basically what you're doing is getting it ready for the new key that you just had cut. So here's my new key. Turn it over about 8 times and it starts. It starts my engine right up. So that's pretty cool. And I still keep my two original keys and I'm glad I have them, because if you don't have them, this project will not work. And then you have a new key. You can keep that as a spare. And keep in mind, I had my door open the entire time and I had it unlocked. So if you get stuck and you only have one key, you're going to be in trouble. So take advantage of knowing where your two keys are and buy a spare, have it cut, buy a locksmith, and it will work. So this is one of my most popular videos. Let me know what you think. I'm glad you watched. And if you got any suggestions or comments, let me know. I think other people will be watching this video so it can be helpful. Also, thumbs up, please subscribe, and give the thanks. Look for the thanks to send me a cup of coffee.